As you guys all know, I write articles on TonyBatman.com, so I figured why not interview Kitten for an article. So those that didn't get to see the previous shows will kind of understand these questions. Now, explain the reason why you chose to leave porn.
Why I chose to leave porn? I think porn chose me to leave. No, I'm just kidding.
It was a request.
It was time. I can't even think of another answer besides saying it was time. Let's put it this way. If I were still making top dollar and or either had made different investments, I might have stayed in it. I don't know because I didn't. You know, so I can't do the shoulda, woulda, coulda because I hate doing that. So it was the choices that I made, where I wanted to be in my life and where I foresee myself going in my future, it was just time for me to go. It was time for me to leave the mark that I left on porn. And I still get fans saying, oh, no, you shouldn't leave. You're still hot in the game. Well, great. I want to be like Sex in the City. Leave when I'm on top. Just I don't want to stay any longer. I don't want to oversaturate myself. I don't want to do that. I mean, I've done over 400 films. I've worked with some of the top best companies. I've worked for internet. I've done my own stuff. I've traveled the world. It was time. I can definitely leave and say that I've been completely satisfied with my being in this business, with the friends that I've made, lifelong friends, family that I've introduced into doing porn with me, friends that I've talked into doing porn with me. We won't name names. Name names. Well, I brought Vanessa Blue into this business. Hello. I brought her in. Everybody else thought that she brought me in. No, dog. It was the other way around. I brought her in. Anyway, so it was time. I mean, I know people out there dislike me, and I know people out there that love me. It was just time. I've made my mark, and it's time, and I can take my experiences from being in pornography, being a sex worker. Let's just go leave a roundabout. Being a sex worker, and I can take it with me onto my field into the next area and the next career goal that I'm doing. Because, you know, with personal training, you got to treat them the same way. Make them feel that they're number one. Make them want to spend that money because, you know, not necessarily for sexual reasons, but for their health reasons now. So I'm taking what I learned in this business and I'm transferring it onto being a CPT. So it's great. It's great. So there it is.
Nice. All right. So when you actually decided I'm not doing it anymore. I mean, originally you came back to do it just features only.
Mm-hmm.
Now, now that you were doing your movies, boom, 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 all of a sudden you stopped. Was it kind of a lifestyle shock? Was it a mental shock? How did it affect you?
You know, when I stopped doing movies, now the last movie that I did was for Brazzers, which I
saw those pictures online the other day, and you look fucking hot.
Thanks a lot.
Hot.
Yeah, it was for Mofo, right? Mofo. It was. I looked at it. One of the Twitter fans, they showed it to me, and it was great. I looked at myself, I was like, wow, that's hot. But when I went on set, I felt nothing, which means that it was time for me to go. That was my true
initial. So you knew that was the last time?
That was the last time, yeah. Because I've said before, it was my last time shooting. I've done it at least five times.
Twice in the last 2 years.
Right. I've said it's my last time shooting, and I ended up shooting again, which means I wasn't ready mentally. When I shot for Brazzers, and I walked on set, and I was with a guy, the sex was okay. It wasn't like it was bad. He was a good-looking guy. Beautiful. You know me, I love my Europeans. European guy.
Accents,
yeah. And I felt nothing. I felt nothing. I was like, okay, I'm done. Same thing when I tried to become a stripper again because I wanted to bring in some money because I had none. I was like, oh my God, what am I going to do? Got on set. I looked at myself. I was like, wow, I look hot. I felt nothing. I was like, I can't do it. I'm done.
The thrill, the excitement was gone.
It was gone. Yeah, I need something that's going to challenge me. And porn has challenged me, and I've been challenged, and it's time to move forward.
So you conquered. So you figured out with this new investment in your life by going into, you know, the personal trainer that it'll mentally challenge you more too?
Oh my God, it's already mentally challenging. You know? Are you kidding me? I've learned kinesiology within 5 months. Now that's, I'm taking a, I literally had to learn the anatomy of the human body, the mechanics of the human body, the kinetic chain, the muscular nuances of what does this and why it does it within a 5 minute. It was only supposed to be 120 days, and I had to end up postponing my test because I learned exactly what these kids are going to school for at universities, and it's just like, are you kidding me? Yeah, this is a challenge. Are you kidding me?
This is real.
This is a challenge. Yeah. So yeah, I'm actually quite pleased. With me being a Gemini, you know this. Mm-hmm. I need something that is going to stimulate me on a constant basis, and this has truly stimulated me on a constant basis. I wake up thinking about training. I go to sleep thinking about training.
That's true.
Right. You know, it constantly. So I mean, those who follow me on Twitter, you'll hear me. I mean, you hear me. You know, because you follow me. I'm constantly, that's all I talk about. So yes, this is a new challenge that I needed in my life, and I'm quite pleased. I'm very pleased. I can't wait to take my test on Friday or Saturday.
Okay, we only got 2 more minutes left, so my only final question is, now that it's all said and done with, how do you want to be remembered in the industry from your peers or your fans? Promotely?
Promotely?
Is that a new word? It is a new promotely. Word today, damn it.
Tony just made a new word.
Word of the day, promotely.
Play me Scrabble, I'll kick your ass.
How do I want to be
remembered?
Remembered
in the industry, whether it be with your peers or your fans?
You know what? The way that I am remembered, I don't know. You would have to ask my peers and my fans, how do they remember me? Because, I mean,
But how would you like to be remembered?
I would like to be remembered as just me. Fun-loving, gracious, caring, giving, kind, little narcissistic, never stuck up. Usually on time, loves to have fun on set, and can throw down some vodka with the best of them.
Okay. All right.
You know how I'll remember you?
How are you going to remember me?
On her back?
No.
No? Okay, sorry.
You got to deal with this all the time, dude. I'm telling her now.
No, I will remember you as the real kitten.
The real kitten.
The real kitten.
Eloquently put.
Lots of imitators, but there's only one.
And that's coming from Sinnamon Love. Thank you so much. Yay.
Love. I appreciate